This is the FM Gold Channel of All India Radio. In the program News Analysis, we now bring you a discussion on political situation in Jammu and Kashmir. The participants are Rahul Jalali, political analyst, and Sudhir Ranjan Sen, journalist.
In a rather sudden move, the Jammu and Kashmir governor dissolved the state assembly soon after both the PDP, the NC, and we had a counterclaim coming in from the Jammu and Kashmir People's Conference to stake of government there, Rahul Jalali. If I were to throw the first question at you, how do you look at all of a sudden the PDP and the NC coming together?
Well, I think for every Kashmiri, and it's like who done it right out of Sherlock Holmes. Look at the scene, the series of events. It starts day before yesterday, late afternoon, when the news of Muzaffar Beg tweeting about his affection for Sajjad Lone comes out. Subsequently, there is speculation all over that Sajjad Lone will take claim and become the chief minister because section of PDP is going to go there. Next morning, some things happen, and by late morning, the next day, you have another announcement saying a Mahagathbandhan is there in shape and a new alliance has been worked out, which is between Congress, National Conference and PDP. So again, 3 years ago you had North Pole and South Pole joining, you have a repeat of North Pole, South Pole joining, which leaves everyone baffled. Because look at the kind of statements which come. So again, we go to town and we say a new government is going to be formed with Mr. Altaf Bukhari as chief minister. That is the first speculation. Meanwhile, every media outlet decided that a new front of these three people are going to form the government and the chief minister is in place and everything has been worked out. But one little statement was overlooked by everyone, and that was Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad's statement, which stated that nothing has been decided as yet, the talks are still on and decision would be taken later on. And finally, you know what happened, Mehbooba Mufti staked claim, Sajjad Lone, who was in London, staked claim on WhatsApp, one through fact, and the governor dissolved it. I personally feel governor probably had no choice, because look at the series of events and the way they went about. It had left room open for A, which I think is very important in the context of Kashmir, of non-stable government. This government wouldn't have lasted. Secondly, also the room for horse trading was very much there. Now, who would have traded is a separate question.
Cannot also forget that Kashmir is a border state, requires a very stable administration. Everybody knows the kind of interference that we see from neighboring countries to try and destabilize the politics there, the situation there, and therefore have a cascading effect on the entire country. But going back, we saw a counterclaim coming from Sajjad Lone. Politically, how do you see that?
Well, I think in this case, everyone seemed to be jumping the gun. Because in hindsight, if you look at it, did Mehbooba Mufti had assured support from the two parties, which is National Conference and Congress? I doubt it. Because if you look at it, the leaders of both these organizations, National Conference and Congress, hadn't met, hadn't decided. Their meeting was scheduled today, National Conference, in the afternoon, to take a decision whether to go in alliance or not. Congress was supposed to meet tomorrow. So the decision has not been cemented, and she sent this letter. I think Sajjad quickly responded to Mehbooba's attempt and also staked claim. But these claims, I mean, if you go through Mehbooba's letter, it says, according to media reports. Now, I don't think media reports become the basis of alliances. I think that was flawed. Maybe if both of them jumped the gun. So obviously, and look, also in Kashmir, what is the ground situation? Ground situation is that terrorism is taking a beating. The kind of success which the security forces have scored is really commendable. Secondly, there is a panchayat elections going on, and panchayat polls have registered a very healthy percentage of votes, especially in an area like, I'll give you an example, Kupwara, around almost 70%,
yes.
You know, which is the hotbed of terrorism. Mm. Number of candidates in panchayat polls is quite a sizable number. So all these factors definitely played role. And I think the governor is carrying on a certain strategy about Kashmir. So all this would have been disrupted. So I think what he did, given these circumstances, he probably had no other option but to do what he did.
So looking ahead, now that we have seen, so to say, dramatic political developments, which all political pundits have underlined, you know, the coming together, as you said, North Pole and South Pole coming together, all of a sudden? I mean, going ahead, forward, what do you see happening now? Because we are seeing some kind of a stabilization of the security situation there. The forces getting an upper hand. With the winters coming in, we are going to see a drop in activity, a huge, you know, huge drop, so to say, in terror activity. One of the reasons being you cannot send in terrorists from the other side. Going ahead, what do you see? What is going to happen?
Well, I think one thing you've got to mark, and that is very important. This is the first time ever in the last over 30 years that you've had an election which has been practically violence-free. I don't think people have noticed that both city council elections and panchayat elections did not have an iota of violence. No killings, nothing, no bloodshed. So this is a huge achievement on the part of the security forces and points to a direction of where Kashmir is going. So I think don't overlook that. Most people don't notice this or have forgotten to notice it. The commendable success of the security forces in dealing with violence. Secondly, you have in place a democratic process, which is, I'm talking of the panchayat election, which is giving grassroots democracy a chance in Kashmir. Look, panchayat elections were held last, 80% polling, but those almost 35,000 panchas who were elected did not get any rights. The center now has promised power to the panchayat level and also money. I think this is next thing which is crucial, which should happen.
It's going to change the ground situation.
Exactly, the scenario in Kashmir. This is one. And I'm pretty sure the next move would be assembly elections. Assembly elections are going to be held. It's a question of when. It's not a question of whether, but a question of when. And I'm sure that either or before the national elections, you'll have assembly elections. The ground situation is being created towards a successful holding of assembly elections, and these are things which are in place, and that's happening.
And if I can just add, Rahul, I mean, the panchayat elections that you were talking about, they were not empowered, they didn't get the kind of money, or they didn't have the kind of, you know, the ability to decide on where to spend and not to spend. Once that comes in, as we are seeing slowly happening, once that comes in, that is going to have a huge, huge impact, not only on the security situation, but on the political situation also.
Exactly. So, I mean, it's from one. I mean, there are two aspects which you've got to look at it. Till now, the kind of democratic process which has happened in Jammu and Kashmir, people have looked at democracy from the elected legislators. Now, the total number of legislators in Kashmir is 87, which is extremely limited. And given the security scenario in Kashmir, most of these legislators cannot be with their electorate. They're cut away from them. Now, with panchayat elections, the number is around 40,000 panchayats. And most of these panchayats and sarpanches, will be living within their electorate. And if power and money is given to them, the pressure for them to deliver is going to be that much greater. So there is going to be deliverance to the people for their daily needs. Secondly, this is representative democracy. It's going to throw up new players, new faces. So the binary which you've seen in Kashmir, the political binary, might be challenged. There'll be other faces. So a democratic choice for a Kashmiri will broaden far more for people, citizens of Jammu and Kashmir. I think that is very healthy.
And much needed, because for a very, very long time, although there was a desire to do the panchayat elections, we didn't see that happening at all.
Exactly. I mean, for 2 years, the elections were not held by the last government of PDP. And also look at the money which lapsed. Almost over 1,000 crores lapsed, which was available for the panchayat level as part of the Finance Commission recommendation. That lapsed. It didn't come out for the 2 years. Secondly, even little things. Do you know that the previous panches have not been paid their salaries, which is due there, so it's lying with the government. And little things which could have been done but wasn't done. So I think these are issues which come to the fore, and the governor's administration is grappling with it and settling these issues. And I think people want it. People of Jammu and Kashmir want their panches to be there and they want them to deliver. So obviously things are moving in a direction, and to waylay this process would not have been wise at this time for the state.
I really like the way you put it, waylay the process. Rahul, what happens next? Procedurally, what happens? The governor writes the election commission, then what happens? How does the process
work? Well, I think the next step is that we are on the eve of the governor's rule expiring, and which will be replaced by a president's rule. The president's rule is going to stay for 6 months. Within that process of the president's rule, the governor will indicate to the election commission for election to be held. and then the dates would be finalized and we'll go ahead for elections. Now, the window of opportunity is 6 months since the president's rule. So, the elections could be held within that period any time the election commission thinks it fit, that things are okay on the ground and they can go ahead with the elections. That's, I think, the next process.
Rahul, isn't it a fact that many of the parties who came together all of a sudden in this alliance were themselves demanding they dissolve the House, number one. Number two, again for the benefit of our listeners, the governor's rule would have come to an end on the 20th of December. And since no government had been formed despite a lot of combinations and a lot of political activity happening, it would have anyway slipped into a presidential rule, it would have gone to the parliament, got cleared, and then, as you say, elections would have happened. Anyways, people in Jammu and Kashmir, political parties in Jammu and Kashmir were asking for this.
Well, in any case, these political parties were also asking for this. You know, this government formation, if you look at this, the announcement which came, even if they had formed the government, and there's a big if, this government was not a long-lasting government. They had decided to only be there for a short period of time, then recommend dissolution of assembly. So to begin with, the entire process was flawed. So you don't go ahead with a flawed process. So dissolution was the only answer, and the next is elections.
When you see the political activity today, the one accusing the other, we were not allowed to form, we had the numbers, you didn't let us do it. As a seasoned, you know, Kashmir watcher, what do you make out of it?
I think you should go through the kind of WhatsApps and what's happening on the social media in Srinagar, Jammu and other cities of Srinagar, of course, Jammu and Kashmir. It's everyone is cracking jokes on the political process which has been displayed. You must have seen some of them. So my only advice to all these political luminaries are that they should all sit together and think about it and give some serious thought to their politics. Not jump the gun and not sort of accuse each other or come about with such statements. Kashmir is a disturbed area. Kashmiris are dying. Jammu Kashmir needs a lot of solace and succor. I think all these politicians should get together from the state and give solace to people of the state. I think that's what's required.
Rahul, a lot of times when we see these kind of disturbed areas, political action, people, as you say also, people kind of yesterday jumped the gun, media, of course, one of them, as you very rightly pointed out, that, well, the NC, they were supposed to meet today, the Congress is supposed to meet day after, and therefore the entire question of a government formation or deciding to come together hasn't been decided, thrashed out. So would you call it political opportunism?
Well, yes, it does smack of political opportunism, but I think political opportunism is the name of the game of politics today. So I will not point fingers, but my only suggestion would be that most of these politicians, and even my suggestion is also to all of us in the media, to be a little serious about when we report politics, and politicians to be a little more serious when they interact with media. Let's not jump on issues and let's not jump on our claims and talk about things which are way removed from the ground reality. The electorate gets confused, and especially in Jammu Kashmir, the electorate deserves much more from their politicians and also from us reporters.
Do you think that the political grouping, or so to say grouping, happened when they got an indication that, well, it's going to go towards presidential rule because there is no other way?
I think this grouping, if you're talking of the three parties coming together, happened because the kind of vote percentage which took place in the Panchayat election, that was writing on the wall. A third force might emerge. And the negotiations between Sajjad Loan and Muzaffar Beg, I think that weighed heavy on all these political parties to talk about coming together. In the backdrop, I think that would have been the most important thing.
Thank you very, very much.
You were listening to a discussion on political situation in Jammu and Kashmir. The participants were Rahul Jalali, political analyst, and Sudhir Ranjan Sen, journalist. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. This program is also available on our website, newsonair.nic.in. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.